plank and our depression. I was already doing planks today in core, so ab core time became core workout today. It was a much longer one. That's good. So let's get ready for the timer. So our arms are straight underneath. Coming up, pushing back to toes, and you start. Draw the shoulders back. Here comes the cat. Alright. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. Matthew 1:19. It's hard to imagine Joseph's shock and disappointment when he learned that Mary was pregnant. In their culture, Joseph and Mary were as good as already married to each other. Now it seemed that Mary had been unfaithful to Joseph, that she had sinned against God and her betrothed, many men would have let their hurt and anger dictate their response. Wanting to be vindicated for the way they'd been treated. But Joseph reacted in a different way. He wanted to spare Mary the humiliation of being publicly exposed. So he decided he would divorce her quietly. Things are not always what they seem on the surface. The reality was that God was doing something never done before. Joseph didn't fully understand that plan, but he responded in a compassionate, selfless way to the situation, and God honored him. He revealed his plan to Joseph and gave him specific instructions. Mary's baby would fulfill the prophecy in Isaiah 7:14 about the Messiah's virgin birth. As Mary's husband, Joseph would be entrusted with the role of protecting and nurturing the Savior of the world. The little we see of Joseph in scriptures shows us how to respond to a sudden turn of events that we don't understand. Don't look at me, that's gross. Don't understand. Like him, we can respond to people with compassion, trusting God to reveal anything we need to know and to show us what role he wants us to play. Because when God seems to turn our plans upside down, it might be that he is doing something never before done in our lives. Diane Neal Matthews. Faith step. Next time you're surprised by a situation that disappoints you, ask Jesus for grace to respond selflessly and trust him for guidance. Things aren't always what they seem. And it's so easy to get upset and jump and just get like angry with the situation. You need to learn to stop, step back, and look at the situation from the outside. Look at the situation from Jesus' perspective. Pray and ask for guidance.
Oh, God, will you lay down, please? Can you get?
All right. So. Noah, what is the motivation today? The greatest thing in the world is to know how to belong to oneself. That's a good one. So the greatest thing in the world is to know how to belong to oneself. The greatest thing in the world is to know how to belong to oneself, comma, meaning.
According to Twitter, translation, you belong, first and foremost, to yourself. Others may make claims on your time, your efforts, your energies, your emotions, but you ultimately belong to yourself.
You are your own first and constant, your own last. It's easy to say, I was going to do this or that, but this had happened, and that happened, and use excuses to put off what you need to do. You belong to your own self in this world. It is you versus you. What you do needs to be for you to improve you in that aspect. Now, we do things for others, obviously. But when you are faced with something that you need to do, you need to accomplish, you belong to your own self. You are the one that will make it happen, not someone else. It doesn't mean that we don't go to others for help and guidance. It means we take responsibility for things and we get things done. Draw the shoulders back when you see where I'm at. With time. Alright. Translation. You belong first and foremost to yourself. Others make claim on your time. Yes, they do. But, and efforts and energies and emotions, but you ultimately belong to yourself. So you have to find the time for yourself. Find the time to not let yourself drift away. Trust in the Lord, for his plans are not always as you think they should be. But he has reasons for everything he does. Everything in your life has a meaning and a purpose. Trust in the Lord to show you what it is. All right. Hold this for 10 more seconds. No. Drive me crazy, geek at. Knees down. Trust the Lord in all that you do, and to stay faithful to yourself in the same time. Know that your time is valuable, and always make time for you. Sometimes that means getting up a little bit earlier. Sometimes that means getting this done or staying late for this or whatever it is. But don't forget